Matches Blown.
Hey, what's up, guys? Matches Blown here, bringing guys another DC Toy Box TV review. Today, we're going to be looking at the Dorps Suicide Squad number 165, Enchantress. Okay, guys, like always, before we get into the actual figure review, I do want to go over the packaging. As you can see, this is your standard Dorps box where we get a window right here to get a glimpse of the figure inside. We get a Dorps logo up top, and across from that, we get the number 165. Enchantress from the Suicide Squad film is the 165th figure of the overall Dorps line. Right here in the bottom of the window, we do get a Suicide Squad logo, as well as vinyl collectible, a warning, and an age recommendation of 14 and up. On the side of the box, we get an image of the figure inside. Up top, we get another Suicide Squad logo. And across the bottom, we get Enchantress. Then in the back of the box, we get, again, continuing with that open window design, we get to see the back of the figure. Another Dorps logo up top, Suicide Squad logo, and vinyl collectible. Then on the other side, we get the entirety of the Dorps Suicide Squad line, and we get collect them all across the bottom. Up top, we get a Suicide Squad logo, Dorps Funko logo, and a DC Comics logo right there in the corner. And in the bottom, we get another DC Comics logo, Warner Bros. Logo, some manufacturing details, Funko logo, Funko's social media contacts, barcode, and made in Vietnam. And that is pretty much it for the packaging, guys. We are going to get Enchantress out of her box, and we can check her out. Okay, guys, here we have Enchantress out of her box. Now, I gotta say right off the bat, this is definitely a very striking figure. She is just all types of creepy and weird and strange. But, you know, that is the character that we saw in the film. So, I guess it makes sense for her. Now, she does have the same Dorps kind of design where it is a big head and a chubby body. And you do have a head articulation, but because she has such long flowing hair right here coming all across the back, you are going to have a hindrance kind of rotating her. So that's pretty much it, as much as she wants to go. You can already see just how stiff and tight this is. So I'm sure with enough pressure, you could probably rotate her whole body, but it's definitely going to be a struggle. And there's not really any reason you want to look at the back. Pretty much they left it a plain back and they just continued her skirt right here. So, you know, the hair is pretty much the back that, you know, Funko wants you to be looking at. The kind of like outfit that she's wearing, obviously it is the outfit that she wears in the film towards the end, I believe, or in the beginning, I'm not really sure. And it is kind of cool how they translated it to, because this is just one solid piece, so everything is painted on. And so it is kind of cool how they designed it. What I really like is that all this gold is the outfit itself, and then these kind of like black and gray lines, those are her tattoos. So it is really cool. You can see just some of the different designs right there. She has a couple of crosses, and there seems to be some type of tattoo on her belly right there. What's also interesting is that normally they would paint a line across to kind of split the legs, but because this is one skirt and like I said, you don't really see the back, they didn't paint any line, which again, it's not a big deal. You know, the skirt mostly covers it, so it's not too bad. You can also see right there on the neck, she does have some type of necklace. And of course, her arms, she has her armbands right there, again, gold. It is nicely painted, and I think, you know, for the amount, kind of like design of it, it does bring out some detail. But it still also kind of feels a little plain and a little boring. So, I don't know, I guess that's more of a personal, I guess, gripe or whatnot. Here we have her head. And again, it's really creepy just to see that she's smiling, but she still has this kind of like, I guess, possessed face. Just looks all kinds of weird, but she does have kind of like that black outlining around her eye. And, you know, she does have her like long droopy hair going all across. Now, what I like about this is that they did kind of mold in, I guess, some braids into her hair. I don't know if she really has that in the film or not, but that is pretty cool. They also kind of designed, because she has some type of, I think, bone that she ties her hair around. So they also kind of molded that right here. Again, it looks really cool. You know, bringing some more kind of like detail and personality into the little figure. So I quite like that a lot. You know, and it is a bummer that we don't get a fully painted figure just because of the long hair. But adding these braids, I think that kind of, you know, kind of evens out. And then, of course, she has this kind of like, I guess, crest or crown or whatever right here on top. Overall, it is a cool figure, but, you know, I'll be lying if I tell you this is my favorite figure. This is probably my least favorite just because, you know, I just feel it's to be a little boring. So, but still, really cool. For some comparisons, I do have the Dorbs Suicide Squad Deadshot. Put him right here next to her. And I have the Dorbs Suicide Squad Harley Quinn. So yeah, you can already see that if you're going to buy the whole set, they all match up pretty nicely. And they all, in a really weird and I guess cute way, they do look like the characters that you see in the film. So that is kind of awesome. But yeah, you can already point out Harley and Deadshot are probably some of the more detailed figures in the line. And it can just shows how kind of plain Enchantress looks in comparison. But I'll give you guys a close-up look of Enchantress and Deadshot. So here you can see. They also kind of have similar designs right here, how these outlines kind of help give in the detail. So looks really cool. Side to side. And again, it just, you know, this is awesome that they painted the entire figure, but we don't really get that with her because of her hair. You know, again, it is screen accurate, so I guess I can't complain, but still, you know, it's a little disappointing in my opinion. Yeah, pretty cool. Put that shot off to the side, and now we have a close-up comparison of Enchantress and Harley Quinn. Harley Quinn is probably the most kind of like vivid figure in the line, so I think this little like dullness kind of just shows compared to kind of like the bright colors that Harley Quinn has. So, you know, again, that is how the characters are portrayed in the film. So it's not a knock against Dorb, but definitely, you know, just, I don't know. I really don't know how to respond. And lastly, but not least, we have the Dorb's Suicide Squad Joker. Now, this, I think, is a really good comparison just because I feel both these figures are a little more kind of muted and a little more washed. So, they do have detail and obviously they do look screen accurate, but it's just not as kind of like bright or as vivid or highly detailed as the other two figures. So, here we have the close-up. You kind of, what I like is they kind of use the same type of like washed black for the tattoos on them. So, that looks pretty cool. Side to side. Here's the back. It's kind of weird how she has all this long hair with the braid and he just has the slick back. But yeah. Yeah, overall, it's not a bad figure. Obviously, if you're a fan of Enchantress, go pick her up. She's, you know, be an awesome addition to your collection. And if you like the Suicide Squad film, also you want to complete the whole set. But yeah, definitely not my favorite figure, but still pretty cool. So yeah, that is my Dorbs Enchantress review. Go ahead, comment down below with any of your guys' thoughts and opinions. Tell me if you guys are fans of Enchantress, if you guys like the film, have you guys already picked up any of the Dorbs? Whatever you guys want to comment down below, go ahead, let me know. Like the video if you guys like it, dislike if you didn't, and subscribe and look forward to more videos, guys. Thanks. Laters.